Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I hope everybody's having a wonderful day. Today I am here to share with you how I get ready plus how I do my everyday makeup. This is the look how I go for whenever I want to be looking presentable and put together. So let me show you guys my no makeup face right here. So this is me with nothing on. I just put my lip balm that I use all the time, EOS. So I normally use this first. It acts like primer, I would say, and it evens out the color. It kind of collects the color on my skin. So as you can kind of, I mean, you can really see my bad dark circle. There's especially under my right eye. Actually, I cannot see myself in the viewfinder, and because I wear either contact lenses or glasses, you can see like my big freckles right here kind of mutes, or what I say, tone down, or the things that that are not perfect kind of keeps them calm down on my face and brings my skin color more bright. And I don't know, it's just, I really like this product from Lancome. My skin has been acting really weird lately after having second one, and yeah, start to have some breakouts right here. So I use these two together. This just gives a little, like, really light coverage. It looks just like your skin. It just doesn't look like you're wearing like nothing, actually. But I can tell the difference using this on my skin. This one I use mainly center of my face. This is like light coverage to medium coverage, I would say. You can layer this up and it becomes more medium coverage. This one, even you layer up, I think it doesn't even go to medium coverage. This is more like tinted moisturizer. So yeah, these two I've been non-stop using. When I do my everyday makeup, like I will show you guys in this video, it's pretty fast. It normally takes 20 minutes to 25. It depends on how much layer that I want to go with my lashes. So yeah, and sorry guys, my hair, I don't just, you know, put them up and clip them, because that's how it will stay all day. Color doesn't really change. So that's what I'll be, that's it. And I go with YSL. This is too light for my color. Yeah, I don't know if you can tell or not. I don't really use a lot of products, but I just tap a lot. Tap. My skin type is combination, and during the summer, I get more oily through my T-zone area, and it gets more dry when it gets cooler. When the weather gets cooler, it gets drier. So yeah, it changes. So this is what I do foundation wise. Then I go with concealer. I use two. One is the lightest shade that they have. Number one, Chantilly, is the one I highlight, and I go this. This is all I do, so this lasts forever and ever. But I love that color on my nose there. And with the color shade 2, I think it's the name Vanilla, just put it under my... If you hear the sound, that's my family outside. So that's where I have the most color. Go with this one, I don't really have much, so I go a little bit, just a little bit. there, and I have this a little bit where I have the big wrinkles, which I don't really like, but it doesn't cover, I don't try to cover up like totally. And I have a little bit of this I go first, and I don't know if you can see the difference. It does make my nose look taller, as I don't have much. I do like there, and then I just tap, use the same sponge. Is that how you call it, sponge? So you can see it didn't cover it completely, but it did kind of make it less than what I had. And under my eyes, I don't really move around too much, just tap, and rest of it I go up a little bit, go down a little bit, up a little bit. That's how it looks. It did cover up, it did cover up somewhat, not completely, but when you finish the whole face, it doesn't really have a focus on my dark circle. So that's what I'm going for. This one, I just do really little bit sheer, and the areas that I had a little bit of, and I set my foundation and concealer with my Becca pressed powder. It's translucent powder. So I normally have this one on here, and you know, the product that is whatever it's in there, I just use that to go a little bit. And I use this Laura Mercier secret powder. I just, whatever it's left over there, go with there. Set my concealer, and on my nose. So next I go with the bronzer. It's from Hourglass bronzer that I absolutely love. I use these two brushes to contour. Just dab. And I go nose. This area the most, that's the color like darkest I like to go to give some definition and depth on my nose. It's kind of flat, I would say. My nose, I have flat nose, I'll say. So this, to me, it's pretty subtle, but you know, it just really changes the whole game. It really changes. I use only one time, so I don't do a whole lot. So just when I have the product on, that's the darkest, right? So I go on this two part right here, then rest of the color, I mean the rest of it, the product that's on the brush goes on straight on my nose. It's all over. And the last bit of it, I just go kind of front of my eyes to make it a little bit darker, to you know, make a deeper look. And with this I go like that, and I don't know if you can tell, or I believe you can see, I have a high cheekbone that is really sticking out, which I don't really like. So normally if you want your cheekbone to look more pop, then you go with this line, which I have already a lot, so I don't go here, but I kind of start from here. You can see. And then whatever it's there, I kinda make it round this part where it sticks out the most, and I don't really like that. So I don't go over right here. So rest of it, I go here to make it showing no lines. So it's almost like I'm using it to, you know, not bronzer but blush, almost. So yeah, that's what I do. And on the top, I just rest of it, whatever is left. This is the blush that I've been obsessed over. I think over, I don't know how long I've been using this since I got this and I used for the first time. I've been obsessed over it. I love, love, love Bare Minerals. Call it Golden Gate. It has a lot still, so I don't even know it. I have to buy the full size one. This is a sample that I got from Sephora. So that has a lot of product right there. And I will go with this, put it a little bit. Then I go this, my cheeks. This is perfect for everybody. If you have darker or lighter skin color, it just has beautiful, beautiful color and has a hint of a little sparkles, I think. But it's not too much. It's not like, you know, clingy on your cheeks. It's beautiful color that it gives. Looks really pretty and it's really natural finish. I've been using this non-stop ever since I got it. Love, love, love. It's not too much. It's not too much. And it's not like nothing. So I really, really like. Only use it this part, and whatever is left, I just put it top part of my nose. That's all I do. So I use this thick one by Real Technique. And dab, dab, dab. Then I go like, if you hear the sound, that's my boy playing with his toys. And if you hear the sound, my girl is talking outside. I know I'm a busy mom. My husband is home today, so he could be with them outside while I'm filming. Don't need to be perfect with it. So with this fat brush, I just go all the way over. And with this thinner one, it's really sharp and precise. With this one, to change up the color on my eyebrows. My eyebrows are of course black, like my hair color. So let me show you guys my favorite, recent favorite. Actually, I've been using this non-stop as I don't really have a lot of time to do much on my eyes, especially eyeshadows. These are easy and quick. They are by Laura Mercier. And yeah, I have a bunch more, but these are my favorite shades. I'll write the details, like the names, down below, as I don't think I can go through each one right here. So three that I will use for my eyes. Amethyst, and Cocoa. You don't have to use eyeshadow primer. These go really, really well together. Let me just show you guys that. This I use for just to color my eyes. What I do is I just put it all over. And I go with the Real Technique this brush is the best for stick eyeshadow like this. Not every brush works really well. Can you guys see? I am working on it. Just one time, one layer goes a long way, right? Just do it, but you have to go fast. It will dry pretty quick, so you don't want to leave it long time. There are buildable, so you can go over more if you want to. So Amethyst, I highly recommend if you want to try one out for everyday look. This is amazing. I don't know if you can really tell the difference, but I can tell the difference every time when I don't really have much time to do my makeup, but I still want to look put together and nice. This is what I go for. And the Cocoa, it's darker shade. So for this, I go... that's only what I do. And can you guys see what I'm doing? Can you see the difference that made Cocoa? It's like, you know, it's like smudging up the eyeliner. You can actually use this as kind of thick eyeliner like that. You just build it up as much as you want. Just goes perfectly. This will dry out pretty quick, so you want to use it right away. Made my eyes look longer. To blend more, I use this brush to make it more clean look. So I just go like this a little bit with the Amethyst and go under my eyes a little bit to define. I normally use the tapered brush to do this, but I didn't bring it. It's right there, but I am lazy. I've had this eyelash curl for years, and I curl my eyelashes first before I do eyeliner, because I go all the way like the root over. I don't think you guys can really see what I'm doing. Mascara is dried, so I am going over one more time. Just and then that goes upper. Lancome waterproof mascara. This mascara I used for years, and there's no mascara that works for my droopy, short, not much eyelashes that I have. This is amazing. And you have to get the waterproof one so it stays up, it doesn't go down. Other than waterproof, doesn't work. This is Kat Von D eyeliner trooper. The blackest one they have. I absolutely love this eyeliner. Just really black, and to cover up inner, what do you call this? Anyways, you know what I'm talking about right there. That makes your eyes look deeper. And you know, it doesn't look too much. I don't go over the eyeliner on top of my lashes. So that made a difference, right? I know some people think it's too long, some people it's not. I think it's too long, but anyways, that's what I've been doing. Then I use this to go over the corner of my eyes. To lighten up. Go like that, and I will just make it more natural. Then I go over on under my the under lashes. Just finished that one, and now I go over with the fiber mascaras. This was a new one that they started to make, and this is the old one by Unique. I've used this a lot. I like older one better than the new one, but it's not too bad. Anyways, I'll use the old new one. The smaller one is the fiber. The bigger one is like mascara. But this is what they do. I opened this up not too long ago, but it's already dry, so I'm not really liking it. So if you guys know any fiber mascara that are really good, please let me know in the down below. I really like this, give natural finish, and I don't have to have fake lashes, but still I feel satisfied to just use this even I don't have much. It just makes my lashes fuller and somewhat longer and comfortable on my eyes. Can you guys see now difference? With this brush, I just go like this to just dust out. The lipstick that I've been wearing and really enjoying is NARS Rikujin. Sorry guys, I cannot pronounce that. Your lip color, but better type of color. And I just, I don't use lip liner, just prefer not, like that. And I just go on the top right there. That's it. Let me put my color contact lenses that I normally use and be right back. Hi guys, so I just put my contact lenses that has the brown color in the middle and it has circle lens which has the black, I believe, color around this, so it makes your eyes more big. Let me show you guys what hair product I use. So one, this is from Living Proof, and this is the Kerastase, and this one makes your hair shiny and really smoothens out. And this one, I really don't like the smell of it, but overall love, it works really well. So I just put this on, like I use like 3 pumps, and I just go all over on the bottom area, and I just spray this on top. It just smoothens out really well, and I absolutely love these two products. And I change my clothes to this. It's really relaxed look. You can go dresser and casual. I'll show you guys that different look that you can go with this outfit. It's really easy and it's so classic. I really like classic look because you just change a little bit, twist, and it becomes more trendy, or just keep classic, but they all always look put together. So I like that, and I love denim. So this one I got from Zara when they had sale maybe years ago, I don't remember exactly, but still works. And every season, every year it comes back and always look good. So I will If I find the similar ones, I will leave down below, links down below. These are the jeans, brand name J Brand. I got them from Nordstrom. I really, really love the fit on. I really like the nut finished look on the bottom and goes up here, and the distressed parts are really, really perfectly right there on my knees. Normally it doesn't happen because I don't have long, long legs like a lot of, you know, people do and you guys do, I believe. Dressier look, I will go with my Christian Louboutin pumps. The name of these pumps are Cornell, and I absolutely love the details, the cut on the front. They're so, so pretty and sexy. So with that, I will go with my Capucines size BB. I have a little charm from lindys.com, absolutely gorgeous. So I will go with these sunglasses. I can go with these sunglasses either way, dressed up or casual. I don't really think that really matters. This is what I would say, dressed up, more of dressed up, put together look. Not too dressy, but more of comfortable dressy look. And let me show you guys if I go with casual. So with this look, it's really casual, relaxed. Still put together, but you know, casual look. Denim shirt with distressed white jeans. These are the Valentino. I have no nail polish. And these sunnies are from Key Australia, the color pink. And this handbag is Speedy 25. And just go with like this. Like this, this is my favorite way to wear my Speedy. It looks more chic. And my pom-pom, this is my brand new pom-pom from Lindy's. And I am so in love with the heart right there. Love that little touch. And yeah, this is the whole look finished. Very relaxed, casual. This will be more dressed up. Yeah, so go with the Christian Louboutin Cornell in the color nude. These are comfy, believe or not. And I'll put my flap that looks dressy, right? And summery and springy. Between my flap, I can go with that if I need to bring more stuff. Capucines BB works well, so, and still look dressed up. So yeah, with the, just putting the pumps on, it looks just put together. Still comfortable look. And yeah, so this is how I get ready and do my makeup. I know many of you requested a long time ago, and still now I do get rat ass frequently, so I got to make this video. I hope this video was helpful to those who asked me to do, and it was entertaining. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll get back with you in my next video. Bye guys.